Fluoroquinolones are quinolone antimicrobials having one or more fluorine substitutions. They inhibit DNA synthesis in bacteria. The major action is bactericidal, that is, they kill the bacteria. Their spectrum involves gram-positive bacteria, anaerobes, and bacteria which are sensitive to quinolones. Now, there are two groups of fluoroquinolones, first generation and second generation. First generation includes ciprofloxacin, norfloxacin. Second generation include levofloxacin and moxifloxacin. These are also called as respiratory fluoroquinolones as they help in fighting against respiratory infections. Mode of action of fluoroquinolones is different for gram-negative bacteria and for gram-positive bacteria. There is a bacterial enzyme called DNA gyrase, which helps the bacteria in nicking their double-stranded DNA and introducing negative supercoils. These fluoroquinolones inhibit DNA gyrase, thereby they inhibit DNA synthesis in bacteria and kill the bacteria. Whereas for gram-positive bacteria, there is a similar enzyme like DNA gyrase called topoisomerase 4, which has similar action like DNA gyrase. They inhibit topoisomerase 4, thereby inhibiting DNA synthesis and killing the bacteria. Now, resistance towards fluoroquinolones can develop either via chromosomal mutation in DNA gyrase or topoisomerase 4, or there can be reduced permeability through membrane, that is, they allow less amount of drug to enter. Use. These are the uses of fluoroquinolones except ciprofloxacin. You can watch my video on ciprofloxacin to learn all the uses about that drug. The uses that I've mentioned here are except ciprofloxacin. So second generation drugs are also used in pneumonia and chronic bronchitis, that is moxifloxacin and levofloxacin, in treating respiratory infections like tuberculosis. And in general, fluoroquinolones can also be used to treat conjunctivitis. Ciprofloxacin is the prototype drug of fluoroquinolones. You can watch my next video, which is on ciprofloxacin.